ginormous. You got it, buddy. Ooh, looks like a bug on his head. It's like a butterfly getting ready to fly away, doesn't it?
We all know that growing ginormous strawberries requires good soil, nutrients, sunshine, and water for Mother Nature to work her magic.
We got more. We need to get a little bit more. Hey, Compass! D3!
But on 40 acres of the Waller family farm in Durham and on strawberry farms across North Carolina, science gives Mother Nature a helping hand.
Look at that one.
A lot of work, a lot of challenges. Every year is so different, which is amazing.
It's a strawberry that got a lot of bumps over it.
North Carolina produces about 19 million pounds of strawberries each year. The crop is worth about $30 million. That ranks North Carolina third in the nation in strawberry production. But the state's 200 strawberry farms and the 1,800 acres that grow them are unique because most of the farms sell their crop directly to consumers. Customers can pick their own strawberries or visit roadside stands.
That's a really good one. That'll still make your belly happy.
In states with the largest strawberry crops, farmers essentially plant the plants and then wait for a year. Thanks to science and technology in North Carolina, a strawberry crop is produced every year in a climate where strawberries really aren't supposed to grow.
So it's really what they call intensive management. It takes a lot of care. It's not like you just threw them out in the ground. Farmers have to be on top of this crop all the whole season, from when they set them out, even before that, all the way through harvest and kind of taking good care of them.
The science starts after the field is cleared of the previous year's crops. The soil is sent to state agriculture labs for analysis.
They kind of tell us what we need to do to tweak our soil. I kind of know what kind of fertilizer I want. They tell me my pH, do I need more lime? Just kind of keeps up with it so we won't get behind. And then we prepare for the next year. We get it cut, harrowed, put in the fertilizer, break it, whatever we need to do. And then we get a gentleman that comes in with the proper equipment. He relays the row covers, puts in a new drip tape, and we start all over. I call our plant supplier. I tell him how many plants I want. I tell him when I want them. And our planting date for the Piedmont area of North Carolina is the last week of September or the first week of October. So anytime in that two-week period is optimal time. And so we'll try to get them in the ground. We set up overhead irrigation, underground irrigation. The main thing is don't let them get thirsty.
The black plastic and the heavy irrigation keeps the plants warm, which allows the roots to grow and set throughout the winter. If all goes well, the strawberry plants begin to flower in March.
We kind of pick up our intensity of, we start fertilizing, at 10% bloom, when these blooms come out and we feel that we probably have 10 blooms per, 8 blooms per plant, then we'll start frost protection.
It's just stiff enough wire, this thermocouple, that we can poke it into the bloom, like so. And if I'm lucky, it'll stay, and it did. And now I'm reading the temperature off that bloom.
And that's where NC State Professor Emeritus Barclay Poling's research into critical strawberry blossom temperatures comes in.
It depends a lot on the environmental conditions. If it's a real humid, lots of moisture in the air type of night, we can get frost or ice crystals forming on that bloom, and we've killed blossoms as high as 31 degrees, which is really interesting. Under other conditions, when the air is very dry, and you just have these what we call low dew point temperatures. In those conditions, the flowers can super cool all the way down to about 27. That's quite a range.
Poling has found the average critical temperature for strawberry blooms in the state is 28 degrees. If the blooms get much colder than that, they will either stay dormant, waiting for warmer weather, or possibly die if the cold persists. Because the blooms are the most vulnerable tissue for a strawberry plant and the most critical to a successful harvest, Poling developed an alert system to warn farmers of significant weather events during the all-important spring growing season.
And if you're not working with some pretty advanced information, especially about weather conditions, and then on-site monitoring, that's what this is all about. The farmer becomes his own weatherman. on site. So I can give them all kinds of advance information right up to the event, but once it's here, it's about his alarm going off, getting up out of bed, coming out here to check these blossom temperatures.
Frost forms when the surface of the plant is not only colder than the surrounding air, it's also below freezing. On a humid night, frost can form quickly. Some farmers cover their plants to protect them, allowing the frost to form on the covers. Mark Waller irrigates, taking advantage of the fact that when liquid water freezes, it releases energy in the form of heat to the fruit. That protects it from the cold.
This is the it's not just temperature, it's dew point. If it's really dry air and it's going to get cold, we'll actually start before it gets to freezing because we don't want to shock these guys. It's like coming out of the shower and you're wet, you know, that cold. Well, we don't want to do that to these guys. So we monitor lots of different things and determine when's the best time to cut the irrigation on.
But for all of the help that science has provided farmers, Mother Nature is still full of surprises and challenges.
It's not a crop that we can go to a production manual that was written even in recent time and be able to figure out all the things that we need to do this year. It's sort of like going on a hike and seeing a sign that says unmarked trail. And every strawberry season is another unmarked trail. And you go out there and you look for certain signs of what might be happening. And so I help the growers anticipate what's new and different here. Or this is something we've seen before, just haven't seen it in 5 years.
Oh my goodness!